this is hard for you. But winter is coming. We know what's coming with it. We can't face it alone.
Today, we're getting towards the cold weather. We had a first freeze out here, so some of the guys started talking.
Now, wait a minute. The guy in Nevada is telling us he had the first freeze, and we didn't have one yet.
As a lot of guys are starting to store their gas equipment, their ATVs, their cars, that kind of thing, a lot of guys don't prep them out because you find in the springtime, it won't start. This won't happen. Why is this all gummed up? What's all glued up? And they just don't take the precautions that people need to take when you're storing a vehicle, especially with the gasoline, with the ethanol. So what you can talk about later is starch on, the benefits of that. Quick reminders, you know, especially on the East Coast with condensation, when you're going to store the car, here's what I recommend. Take an oily rag, and you could get that WD-40 engine oil or the top of some Italian's head. You got plenty of grease there. You guys know about that. You know, wipe the rag down. Hey,
the guys we know don't have hair anymore. Where are you stuffing that oily rag, Bronco? I can only imagine.
Okay. In the carburetor, you know, get it down into the carburetor and stick it in the exhaust pipes, up the tailpipes. That helps keep condensation down to a minimum so nothing gets in there with the circulated air. If you have, like, gas tools, power motor, blower, that kind of thing, drain the carburetor. There's that little drain screw because on the cars you really can't do it, but on your motorcycle, your ATV, your dirt bikes, motorcycles, open up the drain screw and drain the gasoline out of that carburetor because I find that's the biggest problem with the ethanol is that it tears up these carbs, it causes the gas to break down prematurely, and you create a lot of varnish, and then it becomes a very difficult starting situation. In some cases, you have to actually replace the carburetor. Varnish or corrosion or crap that builds up in the base, clean them out.
Yeah. You know, the one thing I want to add to that, Bronc, is people should be careful because many times on those carburetors, they're aluminum bowls or an aluminum alloy, and the plugs are brass. And a lot of times it's a straight slot screw, and I've seen a lot of them get ripped, damaged, destroyed, or otherwise unusable. But, you know, what I like to do, and this is just another technique I'll throw on the table, when I store my, usually the lawn equipment or whatever it is, as the tank of gas is getting low, I make sure I lift it so that the pickup is at the lowest point to drain as much of the gas through the engine as possible. And when it starts to sputter, I pour in Startron straight. And let,
perfect.
And that runs through the engine and the carburetor because it will run on that stuff. And then let it stall out, die, and then store it. And I've never had a problem fresh gas and restarting it again in the spring.
Yeah, you're prepping it out right. You're doing the right procedure. And that's what we're talking about. Also, if you're not a tech or a motorhead or a backyard mechanic, talk to somebody who's knowledgeable or hire somebody to come and do the prep right, you know, for storage.
Right.
Because let's say you pay $50 to get somebody to come over and prep out the equipment. It's going to save you a couple $100 on startup and replacement parts if a problem arises.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Where are you keeping
now,
this thing in an igloo?
Point, and this thing you can agree or disagree with. I always raise the tire pressure about 10 pounds.
Okay.
And the reason for that is with cold air, you get contraction, and then it finds, especially if you have the old bias belted, you know, the coca tires, they'll lay on the sides, and it'll cause premature failure of the sidewalls.
Yeah.
By getting it up, it'll compensate for the contraction of the molecules, so when the tire pressure goes down, when it gets extremely cold, right, it kind of levels off the pressure of the tire so the tire sits flat, or raise it up and get it off the ground on jack stands. That's a matter of opinion.
Yeah,
you agree or disagree with that?
No, either one of those works. Yeah, either one is fine. As long as you remember in the spring to readjust and bring it back to where it should be, that's fine. Yeah.
Right, and it's a good point you bring up to remember. Make a checklist. You know, just, okay, I did this, write it down, I did this, and leave it on the dashboard of the car.
So much more at high noon this Sunday on the Motormouth Radio Hour. Call in and speak live with the Wizards of Speed and the Live Eat, Ray Garino and Joe D.